She didn't even trust you with the safety scissors. That's how little trust she had. Right? Was she not even here? Okay, Rick, you ready?
Yes.
All right, let's clap for Tori, everybody.
Said why people would say that they might possibly not want to have children at all. I would not say anything out loud about it, but inside I would always think that that was kind of a boring and sad life. As bad as it might sound, now that I have a baby who I love very, very much, I fully understand why some people would never want to have a kid. It's a lot harder than anyone says it's going to be. You're tired, you're always questioning yourself, and there's a lot of things that go wrong on a daily basis. Cooking your own baby food is one thing that you can feel good about because it's not only nutritious, but it's also really affordable. It's about a third of the cost as buying store-bought food and much healthier as it doesn't have any preservatives or filler ingredients. And when your baby's really little, you only need one or two ingredients for the entire month. So your baby's nutrition never has to come into question. And even if you don't care about your own health, you are going to care about your kids, no matter what. The Huffington Post article about the U.S. Census Bureau says that at least half of you will have kids at one point or another. So it might not be for a while, but this will come in handy eventually. You basically only need things that you already have in your own kitchen. You need a blender, a pot, a strainer, a spatula, a peeler, a knife. And then I really recommend getting the baby bullet system because it's really cute, first of all. It has little smiley faces and stuff on them. And then it comes with things that are just like already easy to go. So your first thing that you would do is start with your fruit or vegetable. In this demonstration, I'm going to use a sweet potato and an imaginary peach. So the sweet potato takes longer, and it also needs water with it because it's not going to be, the texture won't be juicy enough for a baby to swallow. So you would start boiling your water, wash off the sweet potato, and then peel it. By the time you're done peeling, it's going to be ready to go into the pot. Drop it in, and then you will start the same thing with your peach. You'll probably need at least 3 or 4 peaches and 2 sweet potatoes. So you're peeling your peaches, and then you're just gonna drop them into the steamer, and you're just gonna put it on the medium setting and let it be for about 10 minutes. And before you do that, you put a little tiny bit of water in here. So in those 10 minutes, you can throw away the scraps or whatever. If you have a baby, which obviously you will if you're making baby food, your kid might be screaming, those 10 minutes will go by quick. And so you go back, the peaches are going to be done first because they're fruit and they're more tender. So you're going to dump them out onto the cutting tray, and then you're going to cut around so you can cut out the core. You're going to throw away the cores and then just dump them into the blender. Blend them up. They should already be juicy. If you want it a little more watered down, you can add just a little bit of purified water into here. And then your sweet potato will still be cooking, so you're just gonna pour these into the jar. A little baby is only gonna eat half of this at a time, so you can at first just put about a half full in here. Leave all of those to the side for now. Rinse out your blender, and then now your sweet potato should be done. And you'll be able to tell because the water is kind of getting orange and funky looking, and it's really tender with the fork. So you'll strain a little bit of the water out, and then also blend it up, just gradually adding water because you don't want it to be too soupy right away. You blend that, also pour them in the little cups, and that's literally it. You're done making your baby food for an entire month. And another reason that this tray is great is because it just is a reminder that the food's good for 3 days only. This is what you're gonna put in your fridge, and then you're gonna put one for the morning, one for the afternoon, put it in the fridge, and there you go. And the babies, they don't like anything cold, so you need it to be room temperature or warm when you serve it to them. So you can either warm it up in a microwave for about 10 seconds. If you don't believe in a microwave or something, you can boil it or just let it sit out until it becomes room temperature. And then as your baby gets older, you're gonna have more practice on doing this and multitasking, and you're just gonna add more fruits and vegetables and start making your own mixes. Like, you can do brown rice and zucchini, anything that you think is healthy, and a lot of things that you already have in your home. You just mix them up and then start creating different dishes. And like I said, you serve, put them in your freezer and then take them out for the next 3 days at a time. And by the time your baby is a year old, if you eat in any way healthy, you can just blend up what you're eating for dinner, and that's it, you're good to go. So obviously not like something like a curry or anything, you know, that's gonna probably harm your baby. But if it's kind of bland and healthy, you can just blend it up. And if you're already eating that, it's obviously a really cheap way to feed your child because you're not going to the store for anything extra. So in a world where we have tons and tons of time to screw things up for our kids, make mistakes over and over again, your child's nutrition definitely does not have to be one of them. And this is affordable for any parent, no matter what your parenting philosophy is, your parenting style. This is a great choice for anyone.